Hello friends, in today's tutorial, we would be learning how to create and animate an analog clock in PowerPoint presentations. Friends, one important thing to remember is that the basic fundamentals are the same for different versions of PowerPoint, be it 2007, 2010, 2013, or 2016, etc., both for Windows as well as for Mac. And with each new version, there are new and better features for the user's benefit. So let us first of all see some examples of what we are going to learn today. So friends, here we are. Today we are going to learn how we can create this beautiful analog clock and then how we can animate it. So you can see here friends, the seconds hand is moving and after some time, the minute hand as well as the hour hand will also start moving. And we can also change the background in order to make it a little bit more different, like this. So friends, let us proceed ahead and learn how we can make such beautiful clock and animate it in PowerPoint. So friends, here we are in the PowerPoint presentation slide. First of all, let me insert a new slide and then let me make the color of this background to be black color. And then I need to insert an oval in this slide. Now, I need to increase the size of this oval so that it fills almost the entire area of the slide. So, for the purpose of this example, let me increase the size to 525%, like this. And then let me bring the oval towards the center of the slide. Now, I need to do a shape fill for this oval for red color, and for the shape outline, I can choose yellow color. Now, the second step is that I need to insert another oval, and then I need to change the size of this oval to 450. Like this, and then I need to bring this oval towards the center. Now, as far as the color of this oval is concerned, I need to do a shape fill of white color with a shape outline of yellow, like this. And then I need to select both of them and group them so that it becomes one object. Now, as a third step, I again need to add an oval. Let me bring it here. And as far as the size of this oval is concerned, let me make the size as 70%. And as far as the color of this oval is concerned, let me do the shape fill of white color, like this. Now, I need to select all of them and then arrange them, align center, as well as align middle. Now friends, after making the initial background of this clock, the next step is that I need to add letters, like in this example, 12, 3, 6 and 9. So for that, let me insert a text box here and then let me write here 12 and then let me do some formatting for this. Let me increase the size to say 36 and the font to Comic Sans, and then let me just rearrange the size of this text box and bring it all the way here towards the top. And then I can again make this italics. Now, I just need to make a copy of this and do Ctrl V 3 times. And then I need to move these text box to the various locations so that they become 12, 3, 6 and 9. So let me bring this text box here and this text box here. And now let me just change these numbering. Let me make it 03. Let me make this 06. And let me make this 09. Like this. Now, just let me rearrange these text boxes so that they are towards the edges of the clock. Somewhat like this. Now friends, the next step is that I need to add the minutes hand, the hour hand, as well as the seconds hand. So for that, I need to come over here to the shapes menu and I need to insert a particular type of a shape, that is the isosceles triangle. So let me click here and let me insert the isosceles triangle here. Now, I just need to make a copy of this and then I need to do Control V. Now, for this second copy, I just need to rotate it like this and then I need to align this second portion with the bottom portion of the first isosceles triangle like this. Now, I just need to select both of them and group them. And now, I need to make this bottom portion of this entire group invisible. So, I just double click here, come over to the shape fill option, and I need to select here no fill. And as far as the shape outline is concerned, I need to select no outline like this. And now I need to make some changes to the size of this isosceles triangle group. So let me come over here to the size option and let me select the height as 6.5 centimeters and the width as 1 centimeter. And then I can click anywhere on the slide. Now, this will become my hour hand. So let me just rotate it by 90 degrees approximately. And then let me bring it towards the center of this inner circle like this. And now let me just double click here and then choose the shape outline as no outline. Now friends, we have made the hour hand. Now let us make the minutes hand. So for that, let me just copy this and do Control V and then bring it all over here. And then let me rotate it to make it vertical like this. And then let me bring it towards the center of this inner circle. And now I need to make some changes to the size of this minute hand. For the purpose of this example, let me make the height of this minute hand as 8.1 centimeters and the width as 0.5 centimeters like this. And then let me bring this minute hand towards the center of this inner circle. And as far as the color of this minute hand is concerned, let me just click here and do the shape fill of green color like this. And as far as the shape outline is concerned, I do not need any outline. So friends, let us now make the seconds hand. So let me again make a copy of this and do Control V and bring it here. Now let me rotate this particular hand to somewhere here and then let me bring this hand here. Now again, I need to make some changes to the size. So let me come to this option and let me select the height as 9.6 centimeters and the width as 0.25 centimeters like this. And then let me bring the seconds hand also towards the center of this circle, towards approximately at this point. And as far as the color is concerned, let me just click here and do the shape fill of black color. And I need to select no outline. So friends, after making all of these three hands, I need to select this particular circle in the middle. And then I need to bring it towards the front like this. And now you can see that we have been able to create the basic structure of the analog clock. Now, the next step is that I need to add animations to the various elements, that is to all these three hands, so that we can get a beautiful animation effect in our presentation. So, first of all, let me select this seconds hand, and then for the animations, let me insert a spin animation like this. And then let me come over here to the animations pane and do some changes. As far as the effects options is concerned, it should be rotating in a 360 degrees clockwise direction, which is okay. And the seconds hand completes one rotation in 60 seconds. So for the timing, I need to add 60 seconds like this. And as far as the repeatability is concerned, it should be repeating until the end of the slide. Now, the second step is adding animation to the minutes hand. So let me select this, come over here to the emphasis effects and add the spin animation. And then come here. It should be starting with previous. And as far as the duration is concerned, friends, in PowerPoint, the maximum duration of any animation can be 10 minutes. So 10 minutes is 600 seconds. Let me put it as 10 minutes or 600 seconds for the minutes hand. And for the rotation, let me select the rotation as 90 degrees. So in effect, what I'm doing is that the minute hand is going to rotate by 90 degrees in a matter of 10 minutes. And as far as the repeatability is concerned, it should be repeating till the end of the slide. So let me now save this. And friends, the third step is that I need to add animation for the hour hand. So I come over here, add the spin animation. And as far as the effects options is concerned, it should be starting with previous. The duration should be 10 minutes, that is 600 seconds. It should be repeating until the end of the slide. And as far as the degrees of rotation is concerned, let me select it as 15 degrees for the purpose of this example, like this. And then let me save the slide. And now let me play the slideshow from the current slide. So friends, here we are. Now let me press the enter button. And you can see here, the seconds hand has started moving. And after some time, the minutes hand as well as the hour hand will also start moving. Now, for this particular animation, I had set the maximum time limit of 10 minutes. So let me just fast forward this video so that you can have an idea of the kind of animation that we have created. So friends, in this fast forwarded video, you can see that all the hands are moving, the seconds, minute, as well as the hour hand. So friends, we are back in the slideshow. As you have seen, we have been able to create and animate a beautiful analog clock in PowerPoint. So let me now press the escape button and come back to the main slide. So here we are, friends. In today's tutorial, we have been able to learn how to create and animate an analog clock in PowerPoint presentations. I hope that you have enjoyed this small tutorial. In case you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, then please mention them in the comments box below. And do subscribe to our channel so that you can have latest updates about all our videos. Once again, thank you so much for watching this video, and I would be uploading a new video soon. Bye for now. Friends, in order to watch all my latest videos, do subscribe to our channel by clicking the subscribe button. And do click this bell icon to get notifications whenever I publish a new video.